many member states in the EU have adopted legislative initiatives on the food chain, on the business-to-business relation, and on commercial abuses in the food chain. What's the state of the play at European level, and should we expect a legislative initiative at European level?
Copa Cogeca participated already since 2011 in this discussion on the fair agro-food chain. We signed up in November 2011 the principles of good trading practices, and afterwards we continued discussion with the stakeholders of the European agro-food chain on a framework for implementation and enforceability. However, on the 3rd of December 2012, we did not get to an agreement. There were four issues which were not sufficiently tackled within the framework. First of all, it was about anonymity. It's in fact trying to find a solution for the fear factor. The second one was about sanctions. Okay, at the moment in the code, a company who's not obeying the code can be expelled and there is reputational damage. But okay, this is only one element. The third element was on monitoring. How will the success and the evolution of the code will be monitored? And the fourth was on KPIs. What will be the element or the indicator which can tell us that the code has been successful? In the meanwhile, the code has been co-signed by all the other parties except Copa Cogeca, and the Commission launched in the beginning of 2013 a green paper, and they also launched within this context a consultation. And all the elements of this green paper and consultation will come together in an impact assessment, and the Commission normally is going to do some proposals in the beginning of 2014. It's essential that we need some framework regulation on the European level, because when you have different national initiatives, European internal market level playing field is essential. So that means that there must be some equal rules throughout the European Union.